I mean, do you not think I wish I could just do a job like everybody else?
Go to work at 9, be back by 6.
Which what can I get you?
Could I have some first class stamps, please? First
leave all my problems at work and get a regular paycheck at the end of the month. Just stop.
All right, hello.
God knows, I tried.
Yeah, I tried several times. I thought I'd be happy without a story in my head, but you know, suddenly you have an idea and before you know it, you're sitting somewhere making notes and of course you think it'll all be different this time. You think it writes itself, that it all falls into place like a dream. Of course, it's always more difficult. So what you think will take a couple of months turns into a couple of years. And the terrible thing is that you don't know until right at the very end if it will all fall into place. It's just the last few days of writing that I enjoy, when you know what you've got. It's not the months and years that lead up to it. It's all an enormous gamble.
Have you ever abandoned a book?
No. No, you never abandon books.
They abandon you. At some stage, you just discover that you're not the right person to write the book, that you've misjudged yourself. I mean, the book still exists, but somebody else will have to write it, and invariably they do.
Presumably it must be worth it, though, when you've finished.
Yeah. Yeah, well, maybe those days are the best. I mean, the days between finishing the book and before you get the reader's first comments. For those few days, everything seems possible. And when you're finished, you celebrate quietly, send the manuscript off to your agent, I mean, if you're lucky enough to have one, and start waiting. And for a few hours or days even, you allow yourself the dream that he'll love it, invite you to lunch, promise you the earth and tell you that all the publishers will come and beat your door down to get their hands on it. But the reality of it always turns out to be the same. I mean, at least for me. You send the manuscript off to your agent and you don't hear anything over the next few days. I mean, I know, of course, he's not going to read it immediately. After all, you're not Ian McEwan. But then a week goes by and then another one and doubt sets in. He hates it, you think? He hates every line of it. Your characters are boring, they're one-dimensional, you can't bear thinking about it. And then, when you've waited for a couple of weeks and you can't stand it any longer, you dig out the manuscript again for the first time since you stuffed a copy into an envelope and you read a couple of paragraphs, as much as you can bear, and it all stares out at you. Your clumsy sentences and your embarrassing storylines, but nothing is as bad as realizing your overall audacity and wanting to be a writer in the first place. You just see your worst fears confirmed. I mean, that's not by your agent. It's by yourself.